So what's going on, guys? Thank you so much for tuning into the Skater Informant. So yes, Jon Comer. So the reason I've been holding back on making a video of Jon Comer passing away is, number one, out of respect, don't want to just like rush into the topic without actually getting informed and just trying to make a video just to get views. So I saw several people make videos out of nowhere with very little information, just kind of like this spam video just to get the click and the view. So definitely not doing that at all. And also, second reason why I didn't make a video of Jon earlier in the week is because there wasn't a reason of death disclosed about Jon just yet. And actually, it still hasn't been fully disclosed, but his Wikipedia has been updated and it says liver and kidney failure. Now, of course, once again, due to respect and because I am not a relative nor a close friend of Jon, I'm not going to associate those two to, oh, he had a drinking problem or any of those things. We just don't know what really triggered that, but he had organ failure. Now, speaking of a true MBD, you know, everyone's talking about MBDs nowadays. MBD this, MBD that, you know, never done before, never been done, etc. Jon is definitely, or was definitely, the true MBD. Because what he did with skateboarding just defies the laws of the human body, per se. Jon, for those that don't know, was a local, you know, Dallas, Texas resident. If you don't know, I actually live here in the DFW, Dallas, Fort Worth, same area. And I was fortunate enough to actually meet Jon once. It happened exactly at the outside of like a skate shop signing. Like at one point, Index Skate Shop, which is now known as Q Skate Shop, once had a like pro skater come in, Steve Caballero. In case you don't know who Steve is, then you know, please turn this off. But Steve came to Dallas, Texas. He did a signing outside of Index Skate Shop in 09. And while I was there, because I, you know, growing up playing Tony Hawk Pro Skater, I would play as Steve Caballero and would see his videos, his skate parts. And I knew who he was because of the video game. So in my mind, Steve was like this superhero, you know, virtual character that I never met in person. And once I saw him in person, I was hyped, I was psyched. And at the signing, here comes this guy, young dude, wearing shorts, a prosthetic leg, and with his girlfriend or wife, I don't know who that was. And he like skipped the line, which was a very long line, by the way. He skips the line and goes straight to the table where Steve Cab was sitting with his manager. And he's like, "Hey, what's going on, Steve?" And Steve gets up and hugs him and, you know, gives him a handshake. Obviously, they knew each other and they catch up real quick. And Steve actually tells him, where's a skate park around here? The closest skate park that has a bowl, that has, I guess, transition, that has vert in it. And Jon is like, Irving Skate Park has some. This is before, you know, there's a whole lot of more skate parks that have popped up here in the DFW area, tons of them. The closest one to me that's bigger would be Roanoke Skate Park. Roanoke has a bowl and has some vert in it. So back in the day, that didn't exist. So Jon was like, Irving Skate Park has some, and it does. It even has like the half circle, where you can do like the whole, like the full pipe, I guess you could say. It's like half a sphere. And yeah, Cab was like, okay, all right, maybe you can go after this. Like, sure. Because they both, I guess, skated. Both dudes skated street and both skated vert. It was a pretty ideal couple there, like a dynamic duel. But anyways, so I walk up to the front. And I'm like, man, I need to get Steve to autograph my something, not my board. It's beat up and whack. So I run into the skate shop Index at the time, and I walk up to Jon, which is just terrible. Another person that passed away recently from the DFW that was very influential, very, very well known, and whose name was also Jon. I walk up to Jon, and this video is getting so depressing, dude. I walk up to Jon, and I'm like, bro, Steve's out there. I need to get an autograph. What is a sponsor of his, or a form of sponsor of his, so I can get him to sign that? That'll be more unique. And he says, Bones. So I buy this Bones t-shirt. This Bones t-shirt. And Steve Cab signs the back. And I'm hyped. And as John passes again, I'm like, this is not going to happen. I'm not going to miss this opportunity. So I shoulder tap John. I'm like, John, can I get your autograph, bro? I mean, obviously, Steve, I know Steve for the video games, but you have one leg, too. That's pretty freaking amazing. And I had already seen video parts of John back then. So, sure, why not? So, bro, that's Steve Cab right there. And that's John's autograph. So I got two homies on the same shirt. I was ecstatic, bro. And people around me were like, oh, how did you? Oh, bro, you bastard. They were like hyped on the fact that I did that. So I have John's autograph in a t-shirt, man. And after that, I looked him up more, right? Because I had seen him in person. And, you know, life goes on. And before you know it, 10 years later, this shirt says 09 when Steve signed it. 10 years later, he's gone, you know? And I'm not going to pretend that I was his really, really close buddy, but just to know that that person was alive, that person, you know, you were hyped on somebody and they're no longer alive, they're no longer here with us, is a, you know, overwhelming feeling. It's just crazy how to describe it. I mean, I don't even have words. And I look up, you know, his Instagram account, and man, this guy doesn't even have like a fourth of the recognition he deserves. Now, I know he did great things in skateboarding, great things that people won't forget. He inspired people that were also in adaptive type of sports, like a person by the name of Justin Bouchen, and I hope I'm pronouncing his name properly, a three-time amputee that made it to the X Games in skateboarding.
Today, we lost a legend. We lost a legend in adaptive skateboarding. His name is Jon Comer. And if you don't know who Jon Comer is, he is one of the first ever mainstream adaptive skateboarders. He was missing his right leg, and he was skateboarding well before I found my passion. And I want everybody to know who he is. And what I mean by who he is, like truly who he is. I have been very fortunate and very thankful that I was able to meet John.
He inspired so many people that at the end of the day, you know, he did all these great things, but I personally, and this is very personal, you don't have to agree with me on this, but I feel like skateboarding is still missing a big piece of recognition of what can skateboarding do for those that put the most time in, that spent their whole lives doing something for the community, something so positive, like adaptive sports. And how does skateboarding take care of them whenever they're at the end of their skateboarding career? I mean, by the way, you know, I was scrolling through John's Instagram and he seemed like a cheerful guy, but it didn't really seem like he was given the recognition and respect that he deserved, both from a, you know, you could say marketing standpoint, both from a financial standpoint. How do we take care of him? Because all of what he did, I feel like that part is still missing in skateboarding. Whoever comes up with some kind of skateboarding retiree program, readaptation program that helps you maybe get jobs and still stay within the skateboarding, you know, industry, but make a decent living and where you don't have to worry about your expenses to a certain degree, that would be so great. And especially I feel like John was not given that, and I feel like John definitely deserved that. I saw some posts on his account where he was looking for a place to live, and even though, you know, it's not a knock on his situation, it's not a knock on his finances, my point is somebody that did so much for skateboarding has inspired so many people, both people that are handicapped and people that aren't handicapped, like me. Like, I have all my limbs, dude. What the heck am I doing? Am I at the best progression of skateboarding that I possibly can be? You know, inspiring so many people, and for you to be 40 years old and trying to find a place to live, I just don't think it's fair. I just don't think it's fair. And, you know, those are my thoughts on that. But like I said, John is no longer with us now. And, you know, resting in peace. But just something that really bothers me in a way, I guess. You are most remembered and most desired and most, you know, wanted and appreciated after you're gone. That doesn't do a lot of help. Those are just my two cents on the topic, but you know, rest easy, John. You know, I'm gonna hold on to this for a very, very long time. You know, you are only limited by your mind and not your body. You're only limited by your mind, not your body. And John didn't say this. John showed this. So, like I said, much love to John and his family. And for those close friends of him, of his, and yeah, it's not, you know, moving to 2020, making excuses, you know, like in your progression in skateboarding, your progression for anything, whether it's skateboarding, whether it's your job, whether it's something else in your personal life, zero excuses, man. I think that's something I definitely can take away from John's example. So. That was it, guys. Just a quick update on the cause of death on John and how I'm very aware of it. You know, he is local to Texas, here to Dallas. So I thought speaking my mind on how, you know, he deserved better, you know, was something that I needed to do. And it's done. So thanks so much for watching, and catch you guys on the next one.